Before we get started with this video, I have to say this was one of the most fun redesigns slash modernizations I've done on the channel to date. And I'm talking, of course, about the Ford Ranchero. So what we're going to do in this video, we're going to take the early 70s Ranchero and modernize it into something that should, not just could, but should be built today. Welcome back to the channel, it's Sketch Monkey here, and this is a 1970s early Ford Ranchero here. And what I want to do is have a look at this and think about what we need to transform and translate into a modern version of this beauty here. So you can see that the greenhouse is very, very tiny. It's so tiny, and it sits in the middle here of the wheelbase. So that's something we need to keep in mind when we translate this into a modern version. So let's have a look at the overhangs here. And this is typical for the 70s, 60s and 70s, is to have this long overhang here from the rear axle. I think we need to shorten that a little bit in the modern version. And what we need to do instead to have the same space in the back is to move this rear axle, move that backwards just a tiny bit, so that it's not too close to the greenhouse, and kind of do the same thing in the front, although the front doesn't really matter that much. But I think this overhang in the front from the 70s car is also a bit too much. Now, the Ford Ranchero, what is it exactly? Well, just like the El Camino, it's a pickup. It's not a truck, though. It's based on a wagon, a station wagon, where the bed itself is integrated in the body of the car. So it's not a separate piece from the chassis. So that is, of course, something we'll also need to think about in this redesign. So that had me thinking, what kind of car would be suitable to base this new modern Ranchero on? And the obvious choice, if it's a Ford, is obviously to go with the new Mustang. And this is the brand new Mach 1. I love the graphics of it, and that's something that I'm going to keep in the redesign as well, because the Ford Rancheros, the early ones, a lot of them had a lot of cool graphics on it, like vinyl stuff. You can see that right here on the Mach 1 as well. But at the same time, since we're going to chop it off somewhere at this point right here and remove this whole section right here, we need to have I want to have a B-pillar that's a little bit angled like this. And on this B-pillar, I want to have some cool graphics that reminds us of the 70s vinyls, and have that be in the same style as this graphic down here to tie everything together. Now, the thing with the Ranchero to me is that it's sort of like the Australian Utes. It's a very sporty car, but at the same time, it has to be usable. It has to be kind of rugged. What I'm getting at here is the wheel choice. I don't want to have a super sporty wheel like that. I want to have a wheel that resembles these wheels right here, almost like if you're from the US, you know that the police cars here, they have black steel wheels. So something like that, but of course a little bit more stylish than that. And that's what I want to apply, but in a modern form on our new 2021 Ford Ranchero here. So it might look a bit weird, but I think that is going to be the way to go with this, because I want it to be stylish, sporty, and of course be very usable and be able look like you can take it off-road without, you know, worrying about denting a wheel or something like that. Some other changes that I'm gonna have to do to the Mustang here, since it's supposed to be a usable car, you use it maybe on the farm or something like that, all the chrome pieces that we see here, like this, the exhaust down here, and all the trim pieces, the black down here, I want to have that be matte black all around. I also want to have a matte black, some sort of framing around the new design that we're going to create here. So this part right here, I want that to be a cool matte black that is reflected both down here in these trim pieces and in the exhaust down there as well. Last but not least, you see the angle here on the Mustang? It's very angular like this. What I need to do here, and this is just from a functional standpoint, if we want to have as much bed space as possible, is to tilt this back up almost 90 degrees. So I want to have this angle right here tilted this way, so that this the deck lid almost sits 90 degrees from the ground, and we're gonna have to play around with that and see how that looks. With that said, let's jump in to the redesign here, and let me show you what a 2021 Ford Ranchero could look like. This redesign or modernization here of the Ford Ranchero was one of these redesigns where when I'm 5-10 minutes into the work of redesigning it, you just know that this is going to be really something cool, and there is really not a lot of resistance in the work. And I love when it happens, when you get into this flow state and everything just seems to tie together and fit in the design, and all the different parts just seems to come together. And I think that really happened here, and this was a joy to do, to redesign or modernize. And as I said in the brief here, I wanted to make it resemble the 70s, both when it comes to the graphics of the car, but also the functionality of the car. And that's why I chose these. I know this is going to be a clear discussion point here, these wheels, but I think it looks fantastic. It looks so good, these wheels. It's not my typical style of wheels that I would choose for any sporty redesign, but as I said, it has to be a functional car as well. It has to be able to take some punches, and the wheels are the first to get dented or scratched if you go over a curb or something like that. But or if you're working in a farm, which I think maybe some of these people that own this would do. So it has to be, have some functionality, and you don't, you're not supposed to worry about your rims and your wheels if you own a 2021 Ford Ranchero here, even though it probably has 450, 500 horsepower or something like that. But I love how this turned out, and I love the graphics of this car and how it ties everything together, and also the black trim pieces. You see this bar or this trim that goes around this new designed rear end here. I think that fits everything because it's mirrored in the rest of the trim pieces. You have the rear diffuser, the lower side skirt, and then you have that in the top as well, and everything just ties together. And I wanted to cover the bed as well, so I want it to be covered with some material. I'm not sure exactly what that would be, but I think it looks a lot better like this. And of course, we need to have a spoiler in the rear. I was thinking to either have it where it is right now, or have it on top, so right above the rear window. But I think this was the way to go, because it just sends off the design in a very clear way. And if you look at it from a side view, it's going to be a very chiseled rear end, and that's just the way I want this to be. I also think we did the right decision by tilting up the rear. As you can see, compared to the original Mustang, this is a lot more tilted and has almost a 90 degree angle in the rear, where the deck lid, where the rear lights sits. And that's, of course, it looks better on this type of car because it gives a more defined rear end, but also it's for function. So if you were to have a bed, you want to have as much space as possible, specifically in this type of bed when it's integrated in a car body. You want to maximize all the space you can. So having that be tilted a little bit more upwards is just adds to the styling of the car and also adds to the functionality. One of the most fun redesigns I've made on the channel. I hope you enjoyed it just as much as I did. I'm the Sketch Monkey. Thank you so much for watching. Since you stayed until the end, you know what to do. You might as well hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. If you're new, we do these kind of redesigns every single week. Take care, and I will see you in the next video.